Coming to you from Seattle tonight, where the roof at Safeco Field has been closed for comfort. Ought to be a good one here between the Oakland A's and the Seattle Mariners. It's baseball on MLB Network, and it's coming up next. Number 35 out of the 49th state of Alaska is on the mound. What's your take on him, H?
Well, Matt, this guy's really struggled at the big league level. Look, his ERA is over 5 for his career. And honestly, I don't know how many more opportunities he's going to have to be a starter. This is a big game for him, and see if he can drive that ERA down and give his team a chance to win.
Here's Rajay Davis now. He'll get us started in this one under the lights.
Rajay Davis.
And a cold strike on the game's first pitch as we bring you this one here tonight. And HR, you take a look at these Seattle Mariners entering play here tonight. They come in looking to make it 2 in a row as they were winners last time out.
Well, Matt, I really like their pitching staff, but I think the key to this game is clearly falls on their shoulders. They throw off-speed pitches for strikes, and they mix the pitch as well. I think if they do that,
the windup and the 0-2 pitch.
Nope.
And a neck-high fastball that time.
I like how he wasted that pitch. It was close enough to tempt the hitter to swing, but now you got him thinking, will he come back with another fastball? You got him set up. Off-speed, hard pitch, anything now.
Oh, and a nice changeup that time gets him to swing right through it as the leadoff man is down on strikes to open up the ballgame. And here's a shot of the Athletics starting lineup for this one. Dan Plesac, who are you focused on?
Well, this team could really use a turnaround from Stephen Vogt. You know how bad he was last month? He hit 200 on the nose. Not a lot of guys can stay in the lineup when they're struggling this bad, so we're hoping to see that he can figure this thing out soon.
Here's the 0-1 pitch. And here's a slider that runs inside that time, and that'll keep him from diving out over the plate. Here it comes on 1-1. Hot shot down the line, and this will stay inside the third base bag. A fair ball around first. He's digging for second, and he'll cruise into the bag at second with a one out double.
He just smoked this ball right down the line. Take a look here. Hard to tell if it was fair or foul in real time, but you can see it flies right over the bag. Ump was all over it and made a great call.
Stepping in, Ryan Healy. And as you can tell easily from the splits, he's really struggled away from their home ballpark. Here comes the first pitch. A called strike over the outside corner.
Here we are in the first inning. We're watching adjustments be made. After giving up that extra base hit, now that's better location. He's going to have a better day if he does that.
Nothing in one count. Here it comes. And a check swing here, but he pretty clearly broke the plane, and it's 0-2 now. Working for the punch out and the offering.
One ball.
And he missed with it. It's 1-2.
Well, no surprise on that one. That's the classic slider down the way, trying to get him to chase on that 0-2 pitch.
To two balls and two strikes now.
So he threw the slider darting away to him two times in a row. Now I don't think he'll go for it again. I'm looking for something hard inside on this pitch.
Runner at second here with one man out. Hard on the ground towards short. There's Segura in time to first, and there are two away. Stepping into the box, Chris Davis. Not the shiniest of batting average as he comes in hitting down in the 220s for the year. Cold strike at the letters, 0-1.
Pretty lucky to get away with that one. There's not a situation ever where you want to throw a high changeup, so I think he'll try to make an adjustment with the next one he throws.
And there are our umpires for this one. Working the plate is Dave Lawrence.
Matt, the interesting thing about Lawrence, now I think the way he sets up is almost telling you what he's going to call. He'll call one side of the plate more than he will the other. Look at his setup. Maybe that'll help you out.
And this is off the glove of Ruiz as it bounds away. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch.
That can be a tough read as a runner on second to see if the ball has gotten away enough to move to third. You have to be sure you can make it. He was there, and now he's only 90 feet away.
Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2. And this is in the dirt, but Ruiz able to block it nicely. He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Full count. Here it comes. Ah, got him lunging that time as he pushes one on the ground to second. He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. Left for Oakland. A's nothing. M's coming to bat. We're just getting started on MLB Network. Andrew Triggs is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the A's. HR, what's the word on him?
Well, what's impressed me looking at his numbers was left-handed hitters are hitting under 200 against him this season. So when he's looking for ways to get out of jams, he's hoping a lefty comes up because the numbers are struggling against him.
Leading off for the Mariners.
So digging in now, Gene Segura. And he really thrives in the batter's box here at home. Something to keep an eye on in this one. And that's taken high and outside for ball one. And Harold, this Oakland ball club entering play here tonight. They come in a bit of a rough patch. They've dropped four in a row.
Yeah, Matt, I mean, they have not played well the first four games. I mean, they're 0-4 on this road trip. And you just got to put it aside and focus on winning one game.
He dives. Did he catch that? He did. What a play there for the first out.
Right fielder.
And that'll bring up Ben Gamble. First at bat for him in this one, and he's got that average up over the 300 mark for the year. Here's the first pitch to him. Almost a worm burner as he misses on a low fastball, ball one. Fastball got him to swing through it. It's 1-1. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out. And now a quick look at the Mariners starting lineup in this one. Who are you focused on, Dan Plesac?
Well, Matt, I'm looking at the leadoff hitter. They've got to get better production out of that leadoff spot. He has really struggled. Struggle is a kind word. He's been terrible with runners in scoring position. He's hit under 200 in those situations this season. And when that's the case, you start to think that maybe it's in his head. I think he's putting too much pressure on himself right now.
The second baseman, Robinson Cano, is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one. And the fastball hitting 93 on the gun. It's 1-1.
Frozen with a high fastball there. We'll see if they try to climb the ladder even more on the next pitch.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Pretty good pitch and a great take there. There's not a lot you could do with that slider breaking down and unless you can catch it way out front and hook it down the line. You see a lot of swinging misses on those.
And he misses again. Ball three. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And a good job there to lay off. It's ball four as he becomes their first base runner of the ball game now with two away.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by. But on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take and a walk is the result.
First offering on its way. Now a swing and a ball chopped foul right at home plate. A runner on first with two away. And here's a ball hit in the air. Alonso has room in foul territory, and that's the third out. An inning in the books tonight, still scoreless here on MLB Network. At the plate, Matt Joyce. And the home away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Here's a changeup to start the second, but that misses. It's a ball and no strikes. Pitch on the way. Fastball misses away here. It's 2-0. Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0. Jed Lowry will be next. From the windup, the 3-0 pitch. Takes a knee-high fastball. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Now he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. And no one can get there. It's a foul ball. Now here's a ball hit in the air to straightaway right field. This ball's got plenty of carry to it, and it is out of here. A solo home run there for Matt Joyce. Home run number 5 on the year, and the A's are on the board first, 1-0.
Well, how do you beat the shift? You hit it over the shift, of course. You can't play guys up in the sky, so he lifts this one up and out of here.
Batting six.
Here's Jed Lowry
second
now.
Baseman. Jed Lowry.
Batting left-handed here as he takes a look at strike one. The average right at 280 coming in. 4 home runs, 10 RBIs. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1.
The struggles continue, but that happens when you're not able to locate your secondary pitches. You become a one-pitch pitcher. He needs to start to get those secondary pitches over really fast.
Slap hard the opposite way, but he'll hardly need to move out there in left as this is hauled in for the first out.
Time for a look at the majestic defensive alignment for the Mariners.
Well, this team is really going to be busy today. You look at how this pitcher's been struggling all season. All you got to do is look at that ERA. That tells me he's given up a lot of balls hit, and the defense is going to be very, very busy in this one.
Trevor Plouffe comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. Smoked on the ground up the middle, and that finds its way through for a base hit.
A lot of base hits up the middle. Set your sights up the alleys and try to take it back up the middle hard like he did right here. Nice job.
Yonder Alonso.
Here's Yonder Alonso as he sends it on the ground to first. And that's through for a hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Well, he's been on a bit of a cold streak, and he gets a base hit there. That's the kind of hit. He didn't hit it hard. This is one of those that you need to get in the hit column. This is a good jump start for him.
Stepping in now, Adam Rosales. He'll swing and lift a ball foul off to the left and out of play. Ready with the nothing and one pitch.
No, that
Good changeup that time, but he wouldn't bite on it.
The intent with that changeup away was one thing and one thing only. Get a double play ball. Nice job to lay off it at the plate, though.
First and second now, one man out. Zero. 1-1 pitch is a slider that's cut on and missed for strike two. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. This is line to left. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit. Plouffe rounds third and is digging for the plate. Now the relay home. And he is in there at the plate. It's now a 2-0 game. Digging in to try it again. Rajay Davis, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Here comes the first pitch. Takes a fastball on the inside corner. Runners are at first and second with one away. And boy, was he ever fooled on that pitch. It's 0-2 now.
Now that's what a slider's supposed to look like. Great execution starts off the plate and makes him reach.
And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner.
Wow, kind of an interesting pitch call there. The batter flailed at the pitch away on the previous one, so you'd think you'd go right back there, but instead they decided to come in, make him prove he can adjust before you do.
And a big curveball is in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone.
It's never a good look to strike out looking, but it's way worse when you do it with a guy in scoring position. Those are the times you really want to see a guy battle and at least put the ball in play.
Into the box, Stephen Vogt, as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike. Twos all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. Hoping to limit the damage, here's the pitch. And this is down for extra bases, and with two out, this might get them both home. The runner scores from second. Rosales is on his way home, and not in time as the second run scores.
They say when it rains, it pours, and it's pouring out there right now. Drives in two more with that shot, making it four runs in the inning. This inning is starting to get away from him.
And look out as that one ran in and got him.
Well, no one really likes getting plunked by a pitch, but as long as it doesn't do too much damage, most guys will take it any day. A free pass can be a big deal if the guys behind you can make it hurt for the pitcher.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Chris Davis is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one.
I like that take right there. I know it's a strike, but man, they're making him work. He's been struggling early, and now they're making him work even more. You got to stay within your game plan and be patient, and I think this is a good plan right now.
And he lays off for ball one.
You know, guys, these hitters have had some great looks at that slider so far, and clearly they're all on the same page. The plan is simple. Lay off that slider and make him bring up something straight in the strike zone.
Davis waits on the 1-1. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as this side is retired. Settling in now, Kyle Seager. And they've got some work to do early on. Down 4-0 already.
Seager.
And there's one well above the zone for a ball. It's sliced hard on the ground. Lou fields it cleanly. And the throw on to first will take care of him. So he's thrown out by the only man standing on the left side of the infield. One away.
Now let's take a look at the A's defensively, brought to you by Majestic. And I'm looking at first base at Yonder Alonso. When I watch him pick a ball to the dirt, it reminds me of when, one, he was a catcher, but two, his brother-in-law is Manny Machado. Imagine the workouts they have in the offseason.
Danny Valencia started to go around, but it's a called strike, 0-1. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. A changeup that just nips the outside of the zone. Bases are empty, one man out. Here's a high pop-up calling for it. Alonso, he hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Batting seventh, left fielder, Guillermo.
That'll bring in Guillermo Heredia now. He begins playing this one with his batting average over the 310 plateau. Here's the first pitch to him. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Crowds him a bit with a fastball there, and it's to 1-1. Here it comes. Chopped weakly to the left. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Again, with two outs, the pitcher was mentally in the dugout already. Now he's got to regroup and find a way to get out of this. Hard not to feel for the guy.
Set to get his evening at the plate started, Carlos Ruiz. And it's been a real struggle for him with the bat so far this year, looking to get things turned around in a hurry. From the belt, kicks and deals. Squared that one up just a little late. Comes set and the 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. And prior to the 0-2, we'll move to first. And he'll get back in safely. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 0-2 pitch. And the 0-2 here is fought off at the plate, and we'll do it again.
He's just fouling him off till he gets something he wants to hit.
Skied into straightaway right. Joyce is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. One left for Seattle. They're down 4-0. Here's Matt Joyce now. He'll step in leading to lead it Oakland. Off in the top of the third.
Right fielder, Matt Joyce.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Fastball, and oh, he has to bend out of the way of that one.
That's old school baseball right there, boy. Woo! Last at bat, he hits a home run off him. This time, take the plate back. First pitch, you knock him off the plate. That's old school. That's my plate.
That misses. It's 2-0 now to the Oakland right fielder.
Well, clearly they didn't forget what he did last time with the home run, because they are really pitching him careful right here. And now they're 2-0 and behind the count again.
High and away, not close. 3-0.
Just a little bit off to start the third now. That's three straight balls.
Ready with the 3-0 pitch. A high fastball is in there. Here comes the 3-1 pitch. And he makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
Hey, when a guy homers off you early in the game, the last thing you want to do is challenge him and maybe have him do it again. He was a lot more careful with him there.
digging in for his second at bat, Jed Lowrie. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. He's set and the pitch. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. From the belt, kicks and deals. Up and in here as he had to bend out of danger. Lowrie waits, the 1-1. A fastball right over the outside corner.
We are watching him reach back and just challenge it with the fastball. Now we got a 1-2 count, and that's three fastballs in a row.
Slowly hit to first. I don't think they can get two. Segura for one, but no real shot at two as he's safe easily at first.
Third baseman
stepping in and ready for another shot, Trevor Plouffe. He singled his last time up. Now a slider, and he gets ahead of him here, 0-1. Runners on first with one down. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Oh and two, here it comes. And that slider's almost in the dirt. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Breaking ball there is down. Good job of laying off. It's back to 2-2.
He went with the off speed there once he got him to 0-2, but now that they both missed, I think we'll see more of a challenge pitch here. You don't have to give in, but you can't be too cute either.
Sharp ground ball to third. Cano for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. More. So coming to the plate, Jerrod Dyson. The average for him entering play, not far north of 200. First offering on its way. Now a bunt attempt here. This gets foul. It's 0-1. The 0-1 delivery. Fastball misses inside. It's even at one. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Now a bunt attempt here, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Fastball stays way up that time for ball two. A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2. Now he gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate.
He's clearly looking to hit off the fastball and adjust. That's a pretty good swing after seeing two fastballs now in a row.
And good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third.
Hey, they haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Gene Segura is in for his second plate appearance as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0.
This is the situation where there's a lot of pressure on the infielders if the ball's put in play on the ground. Both the guy at first and at the plate are burners, so a double play is going to be tough. Even getting one out could be a challenge.
1-0 count. Here it is. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. There to take it is Alonso, one away.
Right fielder number 16.
And that'll bring up Ben Gamble. 0 for 1 here in the early going. He's ready. Here's the first offering. And a pitch out. Nothing doing, though, and that's ball one. The set and the 1-0 pitch. And he gets the call that time for strike number one.
Well, I like that, taking that strike right there. Look, he's already walked a couple guys early. He's not throwing the ball consistently in the zone. You have to be patient and make him work.
Pitch is a called strike, the throw, and it skips in as he steals the bag easily.
It's a little surprising to see them risking base runners by stealing down this many early in the game, but they're choosing to be aggressive.
Oh, and while we talk, that pitch got away and ended up hitting him, so he'll head down to first on the hit by pitch.
Second baseman, Robinson.
Ready for another chance? Robinson Cano. He drew a base on balls his first time up. First pitch on its way. Takes a look at a strike over the inside corner.
Look, this is a big half inning. Look, they're down a little bit right now, but if they get something going, it's still early in the game. This is a huge inning and a huge at bat.
And another strike. Good fastball under the hands. It's 0-2.
He's attacking this hitter a lot more aggressively than he did the first time when he faced him and issued a walk, coming right after him here.
First and second now, one man out. Ball swung on and hit high down the line in left, but it'll get back in among the crowd, so the count holds at 0-2. Here's another 0-2. And that one stayed too low, apparently.
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt, but he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning.
That was aggressive pitching in that at bat, and I like seeing that. He showed all hard stuff until the fifth and final pitch for the strikeout. When you work off your hard stuff, it really opens up your secondary pitches to be more deceptive.
Here's Nelson Cruz now, as he'll watch a slider that runs out of the strike zone away for ball one. Two on, two out for him here in the third. Trying to hang a zero, here's the pitch. Oh, and there's a drive to deep left center. You can pretty much forget about this one. This is way out of here. So a three-run shot to left center, number 10 for him on the year, as it's trimmed to a 4-3 game now. So here it is again, accompanied by ShowTrack. Great exit velocity, and the projected distance comes back at over 470 feet. An impressive thing to watch when it happened, and even more impressive to quantify with the numbers. Here's the third baseman now, Kyle Seager. As he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate.
Man, he's flirting with danger. He gave up a home run on that very same pitch, and this time he comes right back with it in another dangerous location. He better be careful.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch on the ground up the middle. And that's through for a base hit. Make him 1-for-2 in this one. So a nice job there to fight off an 0-2 pitch and keep the inning alive for at least one more batter.
First baseman, Danny Valencia.
Standing in now, Danny Valencia, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. He popped out in his first trip. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. Hard hit ball to short. And he'll go the short way to retire the side. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. Don't touch that remote. More on M. Now batting, Yonder Alonso. He'll lead things off first here in this one-run contest.
Yonder Alonso.
The first pitch to him. Hit out towards second. There's Cano. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth.
Now batting, shortstop, Adam Rosales.
Striding in once again, Adam Rosales. He came through with an RBI single in his last at bat. In. There's a changeup over the outside corner. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Runs coming fast and furious here. 4-3 our score as we play the fourth. This one softly hit and fouled off to the left, and that moves the count to 1-2 now. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And a fastball just a bit up. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And it's 3-2 now to the number 9 hitter.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
Here comes the payoff pitch. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the 9 hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
The center fielder,
here's Rajay Davis now, and he's likely just trying to put one in play here. 0-for-2 with a pair of strikeouts thus far. And down in the Mariner bullpen, it looks like a right-hander's up to throw. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Knee-high slider that he takes a look at. 4 runs, 6 hits, and 1 error on the Oakland line score. Heading out towards shallow right, Gamble has a beat on it, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up.
Stephen
digging in and looking for more, Stephen Vogt. He's got a couple of doubles thus far, so we'll see if he can keep it up. Oh, and this just jumps off the bat here as this is to deep straightaway right field, and you can pretty much forget about this one. That is a long home run. A 2-run blast to straightaway right field. Third home run for him on the year, and it's now 6-3.
Talk about a one-man gang. He notched not one but two doubles earlier in the game, and now he goes deep. He's seeing the ball extremely well and punishing every mistake he sees in this one.
Now here comes the Mariners skipper out to the mound, and a change is forthcoming as that's going to do it for his starter here this evening. Nick Vincent answers the call from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from their starter.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Ryan Healy.
Next in at the plate is Ryan Healy. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0-for-2 at this point. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And that's just past the grasp of Cano into center, a base hit. And it keeps the inning alive for Chris Davis up next.
The left fielder,
the changeup
executed nicely, and he still got a ground ball. They got the base hit. He got his ground ball. He did everything he wanted to do. Sometimes it just doesn't work out for you.
Here's Chris Davis now. And this one's in the dirt. And a nice job keeping it close. It's ball one. A ball and no strikes. Here it is. Sharp slider that time, just missed inside.
Now with the 2-0 count and the power at the plate, it could be fireworks time. This is the kind of count he makes his money in.
Pretty good cut there, but it's to 2-1 now. From the stretch. Foul. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. But the Athletics strike for two, both coming on this two-run home run. Bottom of the fourth. That'll bring in Guillermo Heredia now. He's 0-for-1 thus far.
Guillermo Heredia.
First delivery to him on the way. And that misses inside 1-0. Into his windup. Here comes the 1-0. Late that time for a strike. Just a bit high that time as he misses for a ball. Hitters count now. Here's the 2-1. He's fallen behind now. 3-1. Into his motion. Here comes the 3-1. Slider up that he gets a call on. Seared down the first baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Another full count pitch home, and that misses for ball four. It's a leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth.
Wow, I'm not sure what they were afraid of in this at bat. The count moved to 3-2, and they didn't even challenge him there. I can understand being careful with some hitters, but not that guy. He'll happily take the walk.
He's set. Here it comes. Runners on the move for second. Pitches a called strike. The throw. It skips in and he's safe. Close play, but he's in there. 0-1 count. Here's the pitch. Outside for a ball. 1-1. Here's the 1-1 delivery. Grounded to third. Plouffe has it. Throw to first is in time for the first out.
The center fielder, number one.
Coming to the plate now, Jerrod Dyson. No official at bat for him, but he has scored a run in this one. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Hit down the third baseline. Throw in time at first for out number two.
The batter number two,
Gene Segura, shortstop, standing in. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. In there, and it's 0-1. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Now a fastball off the plate away, a ball and a strike. Three runs, just two hits, and no errors in the game for the Mariners to this point. fastball. Whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconut.
I'll tell you, there was intent behind that pitch. I'm not saying he was trying to hit him, but when you're facing a guy like this, you don't want him to get too comfortable in that batter's box.
Hits this one hard the other way. Throw on to Alonso, takes care of him, and that ends the inning. Mariners leave one. Can't cut into that 6-3 deficit. Here's Matt Joyce now. He'll start things out as we begin the fifth. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. First delivery to him on the way. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Now batting, second baseman.
Here's Jed Lowry now. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Too low, 1-0. The 1-0 delivery. Tough slider down low for a strike. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. One out, nobody on. Hit hard toward second, and he makes a great diving stop for the out.
Third baseman number four.
And partner, will slow this way down and have a look in super slow-mo, and you see him just extend as far as he can to pull this in. That's a fantastic play. Here's Trevor Plouffe standing in. And a first pitch swing. He hits a fly ball to left center. Dyson's there. No trouble with this one. And the inning is over. A's are gone in order as they're unable to add to their 6-3 lead. Ready once again, Ben Gamel. He'll lead things off as we begin the home fifth. And we see some action in the A's bullpen now. It's both a left-hander and a righty that start to loosen up. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. The windup and the 0-1. Out in front as he rolls over it to second. Lowry's got it, and he will whip this one over to first in time for the out.
The batter, second baseman.
Here comes the second baseman, Robinson Cano. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Cano waits on the first pitch. Fastball runs a bit inside here. It's 1-0. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Slow roller back to the mound. Throw on to first, takes care of him. Two very quick outs to start the home fifth.
Up next for Seattle, designated hitter.
Digging in once again, Nelson Cruz. He comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. In tight here with the first pitch fastball. That's 1-0.
That pitch right there, he's trying to keep him from getting his arms extended. If it's out over the plate more, he can obviously do a lot of damage with it.
Up around the letters with that one for ball two.
Well, 2-0 now, and this is where he makes his money. If he gets a pitch to hack at, you can bet he's not going to hold back.
Cut fastball is in for a strike, 2-1. Two out, nobody on. Now a ball fouled down the right field line out of play, so that'll move the count to 2-2 now. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. 3-2 now. On its way is pitch number 75. Fouled straight back.
Well, that's back-to-back breaking balls. He's able to foul that one off. Will they come back with a third?
Another payoff pitch. And he bangs it into center field for a base hit. And that means the inning stays alive with two away for Kyle Seager. So a ringing single here to center field makes it two hits for him on the night. And as we show you the Mariners leaderboard, you can see right there his total currently second best on the Seattle roster. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Kyle Seager is in for a third plate appearance as he watches one miss inside. It's 1-0.
Well, that was a big two-out single we just saw, and for pretty obvious reasons. The inning went from totally under control to now. He's got to deal with some dangerous hitters here with a runner on base, and this is how two-out rallies start.
Well, both of those balls have been inside, so if I'm hitting, I'm looking for something I can get my arms extended on. Probably won't come back inside for a third time.
Fouled back. Two balls and a strike. Here it is. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike. A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. One left for Seattle. Here's Yonder Alonso, a hit in two tries so far.
First baseman number 17, Yonder Alonso.
Well, now the Mariners get some action in the bullpen as a left-hander's begun to get loose. From the stretch. And the changeup is way low that time. One oh count. Here it is. Takes a high fastball for a strike. Chopped in front of home plate. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
The batter, shortstop.
Ready for another chance? Adam Rosales. He reached on a walk in his last time up and later came around to score. First pitch of the at bat. Lays off 1-0. Bases are empty, one man out. Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Oh, they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Oh, man. He just tied him up in knots right there.
Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And here's a ball lifted back toward the stands in right, so we'll try it again at 1-2.
Well, when you're hitting with two strikes, you're just in battle mode. Right there, he gets a breaking ball. He just fouled it off. Got a piece of it and stays alive.
Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Now here's the pitch. And this ball is also hit foul and heading for the seat, so we'll have to do it again. Still 2-2. One out, nobody on. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Gamel ranging back. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. Riding in once again, Rajay Davis. 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Slapped hard the opposite way. Gamel is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Liam Hendricks enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 31, Liam Hendricks.
Ready once again, Danny Valencia. He started out the evening 0-for-2 so far.
Danny Valencia.
Looks like a right-hander's gotten up to throw now in the Oakland pen. And here's one that misses to the leadoff man in the inning. The number six hitter in the lineup, it's ball one.
Didn't catch the corner there, but you can see he was trying to jam in with that running action on that two-seam fastball.
And maybe a little frustrated on the mound here as the fastball misses for ball two now. From the windup, the 2-0 pitch. A high fastball is in there. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play, so the count goes to 2-2 now. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. And another foul ball. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Popped up. Alonso is there for it. Makes the play, one away.
The left fielder, number 5.
Digging in to try it again. Guillermo Heredia, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Leaves a slider up high, but it's taken for a strike. Bases are empty, one man out. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. This one's chopped foul right at the plate. The count moves now to 1-2. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes.
That's a ball.
Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at two balls and two strikes.
Well, I'll tell you, he's not hitting over 300 by luck. He really knows the strike zone and his own strengths. That last take is a great example.
Played on the backhand. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out.
Now batting, catcher, Arlo.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Carlos Ruiz. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. Here's the first pitch to him. And a fastball just a bit high. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. And that one stayed too low, apparently. 2-0 count. Here it comes. In the dirt. It's 3-0 now.
Well, he knows it, but this is the kind of guy you just have to go right after. He's not the biggest threat with the bat, so it's time to challenge him right here.
A strike, and it's 3-1. Here comes the 3-1 pitch. Fouled back.
Well, he fouls off that fastball right there, and you wonder, does he love his fastball enough to come back with it three times in a row?
Hit on the ground to third. There's Plouffe. Throw on to Alonso, takes care of him, and that ends the inning. 1-2. Welcome back to Safeco Field here in Seattle. The A's are on top in this one as we get set for the seventh, but before it gets underway, let's take a look at our game summary to this point. Ready for another shot now. Stephen Vogt, already a homer and two doubles to his credit thus far. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Takes a look at a strike over the inside corner. Now the 0-1. Swing and a high pop-up back onto the outfield grass now. Under it here is Seager to make the play. One gone.
Now batting, designated hitter, Ryan.
Next in at the plate is Ryan Healy. A hit and two official trips to the plate to this point in the ballgame. Here's the first pitch to him. Now a check swing on the pitch inside, but he definitely broke the plane, and that's the first strike. The pitch. Checked his swing there and pops this one up. Here to take it is Seager, and that's out number two.
Now batting. Left fielder.
Digging in, Chris Davis. 0 for 3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing in one.
Pretty good slider out of him right there. That pitch is definitely a big reason why he's pitching so effectively right now.
Back to the mound and off his leg. Great support from his infield, though, as that's the third out. Weird way to end the inning. A's are gone in order as they're unable to add to their 6-3 lead. Daniel Kaloum gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Daniel Kaloum.
Here's Jerod Dyson. He'll match up with a new pitcher to begin their half of the seventh.
Center fielder, Jerod Dyson.
And this is fouled back and out of play. A one pitch on its way. Breaking ball just misses the inside corner.
Looked like he was trying to work in a front door curveball there, but it seemed like it popped out of his hand a little early, causing it to miss inside.
A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. And he misses 2-1. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. And here's a ball hit in the air. But this will land untouched. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Now a swing, and he pops him up right up the chute. This may be tough behind the plate. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one.
The batter number two.
Gene Segura standing in. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. He's set, and the pitch. And a curveball that started low and broke lower. Ball one. Nope. And a neck-high fastball that time. One out, nobody on. Outside, 3-0 now. He's set. Here's the 3-0. Takes a knee-high fastball.
I really like what he did right there. 2-0, he wasn't able to hit the spot he was shooting for. 3-0, he made a better pitch, and now he sits 3-1. Let's see what he does here.
He's set. Here's the 3-1. Strike two at a pitch that catches the outside corner. Bases are empty, one man out. Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Oh, and he turns on this fastball and sends it out to deep left field. And I would say he got just about all of that one as this ball is gone, a home run. A solo shot here to left. Third home run for him on the year, and they cut the gap here. It's now 6-4.
Well, the word around the league is that this is a pitcher's ballpark, but it's certainly not playing that way in this one. The last bomb makes it four home runs between these two teams, and we might not be done yet.
now batting. Right fielder, Ben Gamble.
And that'll bring up Ben Gamble. As he'll take a look at ball one. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. 1-0 count, here it is. Right over the middle, knee high. One out, nobody on. A wave and a miss, a tick behind a good fastball. Ripped down the line. And this is past him at third. Down the line. It's a fair ball. Around first, digging for two. And he's in there easily at second with a one-out double. Over to third, but it's thrown away.
That was some great situational hitting there after surveying the field to see what the defense was giving him. The third baseman was well off the line, and he had no chance to make a play as he sprays it down the left field line for a two-bagger.
Now pitching for Oakland.
So a new pitcher set to come on now, and we'll get an appearance from the hard-throwing right-hander Santiago Casilla. Here's Robbie Cano now. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. And he misses again to Cano. It's 2-0 now.
He may be down 2-0 after those first two pitches in this AB, but those are pitches he can feel pretty good about. They did miss by a whole lot, so it's not like he's all over the place.
Hitters count. Here's the 2-0 pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play. Now a spin and a throwback to second, just keeping him close. One out and a runner on second base. Oh, not cheated on that one. It's 2-2. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
Time to focus here. This game is way too close to be walking, guys, so we'll see if he can make him swing the bat on this next pitch.
Payoff pitch on its way. Now a ball hit pretty well to the left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul.
Oh, that's one he's going to want back right there. A fastball right in your wheelhouse, and you foul it off.
The 3-2 one more time. On a big swing by Cano as he lifts this one high and deep out to right field. That one is out of here. This game is tied. A two-run shot here for Robinson Cano. Eighth home run on the season for him. As they pull even, it's 6-6 now.
When that pitch was grooved right down Main Street, he couldn't believe it. He started salivating when he saw it, but stayed back enough to put a great swing on it.
Batting the designated hitter.
Here's Nelson Cruz now. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. So far, 2 for 3 in this one. Cruz awaits the 1-0. That's inside. 2-0.
Wait for the pitch.
Here comes the 2-0 pitch. And this is fouled straight back. Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. Three runs already home here. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
I understand pitching carefully to this guy in the box, but the man on deck doesn't represent any relief either. He's going to have to go after one of these guys.
Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Hit the other way out toward right field. Joyce is there. Two gone.
Third baseman number 15, Kyle Seager.
Here's the third baseman now, Kyle Seager. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Casilla pauses. Here's the first pitch. Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one. Here it comes. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Bases are empty here with two men out. Three and oh now. Danny Valencia would be next if they can keep this inning alive. He's set, and the 3-0 offering. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline, but foul. Two out, nobody on. Hits this one hard the other way. Blue fields it cleanly. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning. Two home runs in the inning lead to three runs on the scoreboard. James Pazos comes on to work now, and he's their usual closer, but this is obviously not a save opportunity.
Yeah, and this is all about just getting him some work, guys. He hasn't had a chance to come in and close a game out for several days now, so they're just hoping they can keep him sharp and give him the chance to pitch in a real game situation here.
Matt Joyce is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. Ball one.
One ball, one strike.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. Pitch on the way. And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
Here's the first pitch to him. Jed Lowry comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. Ready with the 1-0. Line towards center field. But sadly for him, this will head straight to the center fielder as he puts it away without much trouble for the second out.
Trevor Blue.
Here's Trevor Plouffe standing in. And that misses ball one. He's got a hit in three. Pitch on the way. Takes a fastball on the inside corner. Bases are empty here with two men out. Grounded foul toward the coaching box at third. A Ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
Well, he jumped ahead right there with two fastballs, then threw the changeup, and he didn't bite. So let's see where he goes from here.
Here's a swing and a ground ball, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. The 2-2 one more time. This is line to left. Heredia is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the A's. This game remains. Josh Smith is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 57, Josh Smith.
Digging in once again, Danny Valencia. He'll have a new pitcher waiting for him as we begin their half of the eighth.
Valencia.
Fastball off the plate away for ball one.
You know, something to keep in mind, they're really burning through that bullpen, and this is only the first game of the series. Definitely could have an impact on the rest of the series, and maybe even the whole week ahead.
Clearly, they're not trying to give him anything to hit, are they? I mean, everything's away, but he's sitting 2-0. Let's see if he extends and maybe looks outside to drive something.
Lays off a fastball, but it's over for a strike. 2-1. And the pitch on 2-1. Hot shot to third and handled for the first out.
Now batting.
Now at the plate, Guillermo Heredia.
Guillermo.
0 for 2 with a walk for him so far. First pitch of the at bat. In there, 0-1. Bases are empty, one man out. Ground ball right side. And he'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. Taylor Motter will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty.
Taylor Motter.
Ball one. He'll start play with that average down in the low 230s. 5 homers and 15 RBIs. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. Nope. And 2-0 now as this misses below the knees. And he gets this one over at the knees for the first strike. Had him off balance a bit as this is skied into short left center. We'll reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Ready to start the ninth as we get a stunning shot there of the Seattle skyline on a great night for baseball. Edwin Diaz comes on now, and he's just hoping to keep this thing tied. No save opportunity here. Tuffy Gozewich is into the ballgame here as he takes over behind the plate.
Number 7.
Here's Yonder Alonso. He'll be charged with trying to get on board leading off the ninth.
Leading off for Oakland, first baseman Yonder Alonso.
Swing and a line drive, but foul. Slow grounder to first. And he'll step on first for the out, 3 unassisted.
Now batting.
Mark Canna will move into the on deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. Righty against righty as this is taken for a ball. It's 1-0. One out, nobody on. And this is fouled back and out of play. One and one, here it comes. A fastball, and he swings through it to fall behind. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
That's the kind of pitch that reminds me of many reasons why I wasn't a very good hitter. This thing was inside and coming in hot, and he just gave a stone-cold take. I'm bailing out of the way if I'm in the box, no doubt about it.
And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
The center fielder number 11,
here's Rajay Davis now. There's one away. The runner at first represents the potential go-ahead score. Double play is in order, however. Here's the first pitch. And this pitch is up and in as he backs away. It's ball one.
Not sure if that was a purpose pitch or not, but I liked it. As a pitcher, sometimes you've got to be willing to back the guy off a plate by running something hard inside. You can't just let guys be comfortable standing in the batter's box against you.
Inside, and he falls behind the hitter now, 2-0.
Hey, one thing's clear. He's not afraid to pitch inside, right? One pitch ducks him away, then he comes right back with another one. So clearly this pitcher, he's not afraid to work that inner half of the plate.
And this is fouled straight back. Three and one now. Stephen Vogt will be next. The 3-1 pitch lifted in the air to right field. Gamel is after it. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up.
The batter.
Coming to the plate now, Stephen Vogt. There are two gone and the possible go-ahead run at first. Here's the first pitch. There's a fastball that just misses. Ball one. The 1-0. A fastball that just misses inside.
That was two very good takes. I mean, those pitches are just right there, nibbled on the corners, just missed, but he had the patience to lay off them. Look, Matt, he's nibbling. I know he's upset he didn't get those pitches, but they just miss off the corner. He can't give in now. Just continue to nibble.
And this one will be out of play off to the left. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1. The 3-1 pitch. Slider up that he gets a call on.
Full count with two outs now, so if he could put the ball in the gap somewhere, he could have a good shot of driving in a run because the runner at first will be in motion.
And a dive, but he's back. Now the 3-2 pitch, and he strikes him out on a good pitch, so one run can win it as we head to the bottom of the inning. Chet Hinder is into the ball game as a defensive replacement. He'll be the new shortstop here.
Number 18, Chad Hinder.
So striding in, Jerrod Dyson, 0-for-2 with a walk for him so far.
Leading off the bottom of the
now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Into the windup and the pitch. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. And 2-0 as this one's taken low. Now a bunt attempt here, but a foul ball, and it's 2-1 now. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. Right on the corner, a fastball that he takes for a strike. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. And this is drifting foul back into the stands. Now the pitch. Again, he sends it out of play. Now another 2-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Gene Segura stands in as he looks at ball one here. Bases are empty, one man out. Grounded weakly toward third. Kloof barehands it. Just late. He's safe. Despite the great effort, the winning run is on base.
Right fielder.
Digging in and looking for more, Ben Gamel. He's got a chance to end this one and send these fans home happy if he can get a ball deep enough into the gap. In there for strike one. Before the pitch, a check on that winning run at first. And the runner back in standing. The 0-1. And there's one well above the zone for a ball.
And the reason he's working away so much here is because he's got that big hole on the right side of the infield to worry about with the first baseman holding the runner on. It's always smart to pitch into the defense you have behind you.
And that misses 2-1. Possible winning run on first, one man away. Hit out toward second. And that's in for a base hit. He's 2-for-4 now. Oh, and he's not going to make it to third as he's gunned down by the right fielder, and that's a tough second out.
The batter, second
ready to take his hacks
Robinson.
Again, Robinson Cano, as he'll look to follow up the two-run homer he launched over the wall last time up. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. The 1-0. Now it's 2-0.
That could be one of the downfalls of pitching out. It puts you behind in the count, and if you throw another ball, you're kind of in a difficult spot.
Before the pitch, a check on that winning run at first. A dive, but he's back. That's a changeup off the mark, and it's 3-0. Nelson Cruz would be next if they can keep this inning alive. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. The 3-1 pitch. Can't keep that one fair either, and now the count is full.
All right, 3-2 count with two outs. The runner on first will be moving, so we'll see what happens. There are a lot of possible outcomes with this kind of play.
And now there's ball four as this goes straight to the backstop.
Now batting, designated hitter, Nelson Cruz.
So digging in with a chance to win it here, Nelson Cruz, as he'll look to get the ball into the outfield and bring home what would be the winning run from second base. Here's the first pitch. Chop foul at the plate, strike one.
After the walk and with runners on the bags, he couldn't afford to fall behind here. Nice job of jumping ahead with strike one.
Possible winning runs at second with two down, however. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. Now the 0-2 pitch. Another one sent foul. Ready with another two-strike offering. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. can't get that winning run home, and that means we'll have to go a little longer tonight to find a winner. 10th inning coming up, and we are all even at 6 apiece. Striding into the box, Ryan Healy. He'll start things out here in a tie ball game.
Hitter, Ryan Healy.
And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1.
He threw that ball right by him. When you got a guy throwing that hard, you got to really just think about using your hands and just spread out and let your hands fly. They're going to be quicker than your bat is going to get to the ball.
Look out, a fastball up near his dome, and that'll wake you up a bit.
And in game one of this series, it sure doesn't hurt that you make the closer come in, and he threw a ton of pitches. It's possible he might not be available going forward.
The set and the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss way behind the big fastball. The 1-2 pitch. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Pitch on the way. And here's a slider. Strike three called, and that'll be the first out of the inning.
The left fielder, number two, Chris.
Now batting, Davis. Chris Davis, looking to change his fortunes here. 0-for-4 with two strikeouts so far in the game. First pitch coming, here it is. Ripped down the first baseline. And he'll get to the bag in time. What a do-it-yourself masterpiece.
Right fielder.
Now to the plate, Joyce. Matt Joyce. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Hey. Takes a knee-high fastball. Two out, nobody on. Takes a high fastball for a strike.
See what happens when you work fast, you stay aggressive, and you come right after guys. Man, you get great results. Two quick outs, and now he's 0-2 on this hitter.
A pause, and the 0-2. And he strikes him out here for out number three. So after a scoreless top half, they'll have a chance to win it here in the bottom half. A's. Digging in, Kyle Seager. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day.
Third baseman, Kyle Seager.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Now a fastball. Look out as he has to duck out of harm's way there. Pitch on the way. And that's in there for his strike 1-1. Here it comes on 1-1. Sliced hard on the ground. And a reach to his backhand, but he can't come up with it, and the leadoff man's aboard. So the base hit puts the first man aboard to start the inning for the Mariners.
Now batting.
At the plate, Danny Valencia. Hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line out. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a liner back through the box. And a sliding effort there, but he can't get a glove on it. A base hit. Throw comes into the infield, and the winning run moves up to second now with nobody out.
No outs, and that's a big base hit right there because it moves the winning run into scoring position. They got a chance to finish this thing out the rest of the way. No outs, and they got a nice rally going.
That'll bring in Guillermo Heredia now. He's gone hitless to this point.
Not a great game up to this point, but none of that would matter if he could come through right here. A chance to be the hero.
Now a bunt attempt here, but a foul ball here, 0-1. The 0-1. Now a bunt attempt here. And the throw will come to first, so the sacrifice works as planned.
He's going to get a lot of praise from his pitcher after a play like that. A textbook example of a player staying in control of his body and finishing with a strong, accurate throw to the base.
Here's the first pitch. Tuffy Gozewich is next as he finds himself behind 0-1.
Well, this is a strikeout situation, but it's also a ground ball situation. I expect we'll see a lot of pitches down in the zone trying to prevent the hitter from getting the ball up in the air.
The 0-1. Sliced hard but foul. Look out over there. Possible winning run just 90 feet away here. One away. And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Oh, wow. He really yanked that slider across his body, and he almost threw it to the backstop. Nice job by his battery mate to corral that one.
Now the 1-2 pitch. Hit on the ground out for short. And that is in the center field as he comes through. It's a base hit. And they're going to walk off as winners. They've taken it here in extra innings.
Hey, this game looked like it was going to be one of those wild ones right from the beginning. But when you could win this thing in walk-off fashion, what a way to win a ball game. A walk-off win?
And if we had to single out one star from the Mariners roster tonight, I think it would have to be this man, Nelson Cruz. Don't put that card in your bicycle spokes. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, he played a nice game out there, as did some of his teammates, but he seemed to be the biggest difference maker, so he gets the nod in this one.
Tight one, 7-6, the final score tonight. Edwin Diaz gets the win in relief, his second of the year. So that's a wrap here tonight. Harold Reynolds, Dan Plesac, Matt Vasgersian, thanking you for watching Major League Baseball on MLB Network. Have a great night.